In Acts chapter 4, we see the Jewish officials respond to Peter and John after they had healed a man that had been lame since birth. Verse 1 tells us that as Peter and John were speaking to the people after the healing, the priest, the captains of the temple, and the Sadducees came upon them. The Jewish leaders were greatly disturbed. They laid hands on Peter and John, and they put them in custody. The very next day, Peter and John stood before the council with the high priest and many of his family. And the question they asked was this: by what power or what name have you done this? Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, answered, "Let it be known to you all and to all the people in Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man stands here before you." Now keep in mind, just months before, Peter denied any association with Christ, and the disciples had been in hiding. But now, in what seems to be a blatant disregard for their personal safety, Peter and John began to boldly speak the name of Jesus and confront those who ordered Jesus' crucifixion. But it doesn't stop there. After the council considered the undeniable healing and the boldness of Peter and John, they decided to severely threaten them that they wouldn't speak of Jesus again. But they answered even bolder still, "Whether it's right in the sight of God to listen to you more than God, you judge, for we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." And my hope for you today, as you read through this truly inspiring story, is that it will stir you to speak the things that you have seen and heard in your own life concerning our wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ.